If civilization stops advancing, then that may be due to some calamitous event that erases civilization.
Assuming that you know who Elon Musk is and what SpaceX is, and that's why you clicked this video in the first place, I'm going to jump into it right away. I hope that's okay. There were so many things that were packed into Elon Musk's recent SpaceX presentation. If you haven't had a chance to watch it, the basic summary is that the man wants to make humans a multiplanetary species. He wants us to not only live on Earth, but also on Mars. The presentation focused on various things like how he plans to do that, what's the cost involved, technical aspect of the spacecraft, logistics of the whole mission, etc., etc. The point of this video is not to educate you about Elon Musk or his presentation. His presentation was a bit outlandish. I don't know if it's even doable. I mean, it is inevitable and eventually we will do it, but I don't know if Elon Musk can do it. I am still a skeptic of the whole project. Well, maybe that is why I am not Elon Musk, right? The morality of terraforming another planet for us to live is just too huge for me to contemplate right now. The point of this video is not to debate on the technicalities of said mission or to analyze the budget for the proposed project, but the actual point of this video is to imagine what life would be like if we ever do successfully manage to colonize Mars, assuming that we won't kill each other before the supposed colonization. Looks like we very well might. We've been screwing with Earth for a while now, and it has been pretty obvious in the past few years. Globally, temperatures have risen up a notch. Winters are mild in Canada, and summers are unbearable in India. Cold is becoming warm, and hot is becoming hell. It is baffling that there are still climate change deniers that are actively representing countries and states. So this plan to become an interplanetary species is not just a step forward in human advancement, but also a backup plan. Actually, it is primarily a backup plan. As Elon Musk himself said, an asteroid or a supervolcano could destroy us, and we face risks that the dinosaurs never saw. An engineered virus, inadvertent creation of a micro black hole, catastrophic global warming, or some as yet unknown technology could spell the end of us. Humankind evolved over millions of years, but in the last 60 years, atomic weaponry created the potential to extinguish ourselves. Sooner or later, we must expand life beyond this green and blue ball or go extinct. According to Elon Musk, he envisions a Mars colony of 80,000 people by 2040, and he also talked about eventually reducing the travel cost of a Mars trip to approximately $200,000 US dollars. As with any technological leap like smartphones, it'll be a pretty common thing soon after its inception. We will begin to hear things like, "I've been saving up my entire life to go to Mars," or "I just got a scholarship from the Martian Institute of Technology to study geophysics." You get the point, it'll be a common thing is all I'm saying. So what exactly would such a colony look like? Many writers and futurists have envisioned life on other planets. One of my favorite authors, who have been a great influence on me, wrote a story in which he describes about such a colony on its initial stage. I am talking about Arthur C. Clarke and his novel 2061 Odyssey 3. It is not a masterpiece by any means, especially compared to its predecessors 2001 and 2010 Space Odysseys. But 2061 fascinated me because it briefly describes life in Ganymede, Jupiter's largest moon. I'm not going to dwell deep into the story, but the human colony has just begun in Ganymede. There are mostly specialists and technicians who need to be there to establish a self-sustaining colony. I vividly remember that part because that kept me wondering about such an isolated colony for days. Now, there is a possible reality of a Mars colony. I'm assuming that it will be at first filled with biologists, physicists, chemists, mathematicians, and other STEM personnel who are in the top of their game. Before terraforming the entire planet by nuking its poles, we will have a lot of enclosed facilities and living stations. Elon Musk himself talked about a Mars Oasis, an experiment to predict the possibility of life on Mars. Slowly, when things stabilize, job positions will be open for journalists, documentary film crews, and entertainers. After all, Earthians will want to see what's going on up there, and Martians will want some entertainment. Stand-up comedians will probably go on tours to entertain the colonists. Even for the first manned mission, which would consist of 100 people, SpaceX is going to use the Interplanetary Transport System, a massive two-staged rocket, which is probably the biggest spaceship ever made. Musk suggested that the carrier would have a movie theater and a pizza shop. Now, I don't know how he plans to do that with the proposed budget, but the vision is still there. So I won't be wrong in assuming that the initial Mars colony would have its share of theaters and food stalls. I'm imagining that it would be a sector-based colony. Biologists and vegetation research personnel would be in, say, Sector A. Meteorologists would be in Sector B. Communications would be in Sector C, and so on. Each sector would have its living quarters, observation decks, cafeterias, and other practical divisions. Airtight space vehicles like the one you see in the movie The Martian would be used to travel between sectors and research areas. It'll be a town with borders on all four sides. If there are vehicles that are powerful enough, there might even be tours that would eventually be arranged to visit remote and unexplored territories. If a person in the Mars colony completed his or her day's work and gets up to the observation deck and sits there with a drink, what would that person see? Earth would be seen as a tiny speck, a star, like we sometimes see Venus. What would that person think, looking up at their home planet like that, in silence? Eventually, the first Mars baby would be born. When it grows up, what would it think of the Earth and its cultures and colors? What would be the Martian culture after many generations? I'm willing to bet that it would be so different from ours. All of this makes me wonder, where are we as species going? We don't have an answer yet to where we came from, but it shouldn't stop us from going further, right? That's it for today's episode, but before leaving, I want to ask you a question. Do you think that this Mars colonization is a good idea? Please leave a comment below to let me know why you think that it is a good idea. If you think that it is a bad idea, again, let me know why you think that it is a bad idea in the comments below. I've also attached a link to a playlist for my other videos and short films. You can check them out. Thank you so much for watching. If you like the video and if you want to see more videos like this, please like and subscribe. See you soon.